Okay, now that we've unraveled the strap, we can see that the we've got the ratcheting buckle handle, and then we've got the back of the buckle. We want the back of the buckle to be against the case. I'm going to choose to put it going this way, but you can go in either direction. Once you've determined which way that the buckle will lay, you have identified now the top edge of the Kevlar strip, and just pull it through so that now you've got identified the top of the strap in a way that it won't be able to twist once you've got it on. Now that we've identified the top corner of the Kevlar strap and the orientation, we take the angle brace, first angle brace, and we slide it through, always making sure that the center section of the angle brace is in front of the strap. The strap is behind it. So the strap goes this way. You can pull it out the back a little bit, but it goes straight through with the center section being in the front and the strap being in the back. And once you've got the first one, obviously with the grommets oriented in the correct location, you go and take the second one, thread that through, and the third one, thread that through, and the fourth one. Now for now, I'm not going to worry so much about the guide pins that are at the corners. There's four guide pins that the strap, once it's installed, will go behind. But for now, it's not that important to worry about the strap being there. We just want to make sure that it's always behind the center section and that the grommets are in the position that you want them oriented on the case when everything is installed. Now that we have all of them installed, you can pull them tight and see that everything is oriented properly, and we can begin strapping on. So bring the strap around. Don't worry about where the angle braces are. We'll adjust those in a minute. Close the ratchet buckle handle so that you can see the slot in the center pin, and slide the strap through the slot, being careful that you remembered where the top corner was so that you're not twisting the strap. And then just pull it through and hold it. Pull it through and hold it. And now you can go back around and slide your angle braces through the strap until they're somewhat seated onto the corners. Take a little bit of work, but you'll get the hang of it. You'll see how much you need to hold the strap versus when you can loosen it up. Put those onto the corners. Make sure that you're not covering the exhaust. In this case, I'm below the exhaust. I'm still holding some tension on this strap, and now all I do is buckle it down. I buckle it down to the point where it's still loose enough that I can move things around up and down, and I go back and make sure that the strap is behind those guide pins. Okay. Strap has to be behind the guide pins. If the buckle is close to an angle brace, it's okay. If you can have it in the middle, it's okay. As long as it's somewhere here and you can get to it, you're in good shape. So everything is in good shape. You want the angle braces to be pretty much diagonally on the corner because we've got adjustments from there that we can make. Don't worry if the angle brace looks like it's pointing downwards or upwards. The final installation is gonna take care of that for us. We just want things generally to be moving in the proper direction. So now I'm strapped up. I'm going to give it another couple of pulls. And I'm going to make sure that the grommets themselves are looking smooshed. Right? The grommets will flatten out. You'll see this in the instructions. There's some pictures there. And the grommets, once they're smooshed, you're going to notice that you can actually play a little music on the strap around all four corners. And now you've got a strap that's on good. You know, nothing's going anywhere. You can actually lift the unit with those on, and nothing's going to go anywhere. Okay. So now we've got a successfully strapped inverter case. The next thing that we do is obviously put the extension arms on.